Crazy.
Oh, oh, I'm sorry. Sorry to see you there.
Oh, wait a minute. I know who you are.
I think I know who you are.
You're Tom Sheen.
You're Margaret Thatcher.
No.
Oh, I'm
sorry. No, I'm
not. Jenna, Gina Rulli.
Yeah, that's okay. Me. Hi.
Okay. Hey, hang on.
Wait. Oh, my gosh. I know where we are.
Where are we?
We're at the Nicholshane High School 2016 Variety Show.
Woo!
That's what you're...
That's what I'm
okay. Okay, yeah, that makes sense now.
Oh my gosh, hi everyone!
Yeah,
hi. Oh, this is so exciting! Are you so excited?
I'm really excited. You guys excited?
Oh, no! Numbers. Come on, are you excited?
Yeah.
There we go! We have so much talent. Variety of talent. This is a reminder that this is sponsored by the junior and senior class. So let's have a hand. Yeah. 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 So, sitting over there on the piano is the lovely Miss Emily Kirshner.
Uh-huh. And she's going to help us set the tone off, right? By singing Green Day's Last Night on Earth.
So let's have a hand for the lovely Miss Emily Kirshner.
Thank you.
the OG Bobby Shepley. OG Bobby Shepley. OG Bobby Shepley. He's going to recite some spoken word poetry for us. So let's have a hand for OG Bobby Shepley.
This goes out to all who vanished and never said goodbye. Waiting, quite frankly, sounds better than suffering, but you and I know that leaving me was only coming. Cold promises and constant letdowns that caused me to leave you and never turn around. It wasn't about the gifts, but it should come as no surprise that your knives have sharpened and you hold me hostage with those dark brown eyes. The reality is that your pain has you truly conquered, but even still today I fight and live in your honor. Every time we meet, the hostility is still in the air, but sadly, wars are supposed to be fought, even if unjust and unfair. You two were my best friends for as long as I can remember. But liars are completely forgotten. I'd rather just sit here and listen to the roaring thunder. Yeah, my mind raging like a filter in a photograph, but even if you even look into my eyes, you wouldn't be able to see the aftermath. Nature is flashing into saving grace. But even with an apology, it's really just you trying to save face. I sincerely hope that you hear the conviction in my voice, because this pain that I'm going through is anything but my choice. This pen that I'm writing with is slowly starting to die out. But I'm still writing the script of this movie and building the foundation of my house. Detailed and appealing, it is everything I could possibly dream. But even with the faint hint of your voice at the door, you're nothing but a distant memory. I'll never let you or anyone else try to finish me. So take this pen, take this key, and someone help me find my destiny.
I haven't noticed it.
I know, me too. Oh, that's right. You know who that just was? Oh, you know who's down here?
Who is that?
The National Art Honor Society.
Oh, hey guys.
These guys are so cool. Oh my gosh. Hi. Oh, I think they have a surprise for us at the end of the show tonight.
I wonder what that is they're doing over there.
I don't know. I guess they're giving away clues over here?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's a big puzzle.
Yeah! I guess I found that. Yeah. Well, again, Bobby was awesome.
Yeah, he was.
Of course. But,
Hey, Regina. Yeah. You know who the best genius of all of history is?
Showman?
Close.
I don't know.
Maple Shade's very own ceramics teacher,
oh, yes.
Mr. Smith, the concerto pianist.
Oh, yeah! Big
round of applause for Mr. Smith.
Mr. Smith.
I love you.
Thank you.
good friend, and Gina is honestly the best friend I could ever have. At least I can
say. Aww, thank you. Okay, so, here's Morgan Wapak.
Singing What It Means to Be a Friend.
From the musical 13.
Enjoy, guys.
Yes, enjoy.
Thank you. La 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 la.
moving on. I have an important question for you.
Okay, hit me.
What is your favorite shape?
I'd probably have to go with a square. I'm not really a square guy, but nice even, everything's the same.
Squares are cool, but what happens when you take a square to the next dimension?
You get a cube.
Yes! You know what's cooler than a cube?
What, Dan?
A Rubik's Cube!
Oh!
You know what's cooler than one Rubik's Cube?
What's cooler than one Rubik's Cube, Dan?
Like, three or four Rubik's Cubes.
Three or four Rubik's Cubes?
Don't you love Rubik's Cubes?
I personally have a bad relationship with Rubik's Cubes because they don't really go well with colorblind children.
Well, our friend Ed is amazing with Rubik's Cubes, and so we're going to let you see how talented and cool it is with his Rubik's Cubes.
Fun fact?
Yes.
Ed is not colorblind.
No. He is not. So, give a hand for Ed and his Rubik's Cubes.
Oh,
crazy. I think there's something going on over here. I'm sorry to say, maybe it's a paintbrush?
Is it?
Maybe. You know those paintbrush mistakes? I don't know, whatever it is, I said it's not on this floor.
Hello?
Hey, Gina.
That's me.
Yeah, I know, I said hey, Gina.
I've been wandering about for all the years you'd like to meet.
Our next guests, Alexis and Alexa. Oh, they're so cool! Oh my god, they're so amazing! And they're going to sing and play the song by Adele called Hello. It's so good! It's so good!
See, we did that.
Yeah. Okay, so without further ado, give a hand for Alexis and Alexa.
You are so alright.
was great, wasn't it, guys?
What did I say? Say hi to Anthony. Anthony's here. Why are you dressed like that?
What do you mean?
So our next act is Sam Brooks and Sean New performing Who's On First?
Sean New. Who's On First?
Sean New. Sam Brooks and Sean New.
Yeah, what is Sean New?
No, Sean New, the person. Sean New.
What person, though?
Oh, my gosh. Anyway, again, Sam Brooks and Sean New.
Yes, Sam Brooks!
Hey, Sam.
What's up, Sean?
So I heard you wanted to learn the names of the players on the St. Louis team.
Indeed, I do.
So first things first, you need to know that baseball players nowadays have very peculiar names.
Funny names?
Nicknames, Wesley. Now with the St. Louis team, we have who's on first, what's on second, and I don't know who's on third.
That's what I want to find out. I want you to tell me the names of the fellas on the St. Louis team.
That's what I'm here to tell you. Who's on first, what's on second, and I don't know who's on third.
Do you know the fellow's names?
Yes.
Okay, so tell me who's on first.
Yes.
The guy on first base.
Who?
The fellow's name on first base.
Who?
The guy playing first.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for?
I'm not asking you, I'm telling you. Who is on first?
Okay, I'm asking you. Who's on first?
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
So when you pay off the first baseman every month, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it. Why shouldn't he? The man's entitled to it.
Who is?
Yes.
So who gets it?
Sometimes the man's wife comes and picks it up.
Whose wife?
Yes, after all, the man earns it.
All I'm trying to figure out is what's the guy's name on first base?
Hold up. What's the guy's name on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who is on first?
I don't know.
That's the third base.
What?
It's the second base.
One base at a time. Who's on first?
Who is on first?
St. Louis has a good outfield?
St. Louis has the best outfield in baseball.
Okay, tell me the left fielder's name.
Why?
I don't know, I just thought I'd ask.
I thought I'd tell you.
Okay, so tell me who's playing left field.
Who's playing first?
Stay out of the infield, the left fielder's name.
Why?
Because.
Because it's our center fielder.
Wait a minute, you got a pitcher on this team?
What kind of team would we be without a pitcher?
Okay, so tell me the pitcher's name.
Tomorrow.
Why don't you just tell me today?
I did tell you today.
Okay, so tell me the pitcher's name.
Tomorrow.
So the guy at bat bunts the ball. Me being a good catcher, I want to pick the ball and throw it to first base. So I throw it to him.
And that's the first thing you said right all day.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Relax, nobody gets it at first. It's alright.
So I pick up the ball and throw it to first base. Wherever it is, grabs the ball and drops it. So the guy runs to second base. Who picks it up and throws it to what? What throws it? I don't know. And I don't know if throws it back to tomorrow. A triple play.
It very well could be.
Another guy gets up and it's a long ball to center.
Because?
Why? I don't know. And I don't care.
What was that?
I said, I don't care.
Oh, I don't care is our shortstop.
Thank you.
bottom fish.
Let's see what's happening over here. Oh, there's another piece right here.
Ooh. Yeah, it definitely looks like a neck and chin now.
Neck and chin, guys.
Okay, so
our next guest is a singer, and she's one of my closest friends. Her name is Miranda Rouche, and she will be singing "Oh Darling" by the Beatles. What a
classic!
Beautiful. Really. So let's have a hand for Miss Miranda Rouche.
Thank you.
maybe. I don't know. It's a surprise.
Surprise. Maybe I'll find out.
Yeah. So moving on with our show. Our next act, she is a senior here in Bushley High School, and she is a singer, and she's wonderful, and she's very friendly, and very pretty, and I could go on forever, but I won't, because she's so amazing, and her name is Emily Kingsmore. She is going to be singing Don't Wait on My Parade from Funny Girl. So, have a hand! Please feel free to sing along with me.